Hello everyone, in today's video, I will show you how I created this double exposure effect image that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, so I will go ahead and open Adobe Photoshop and I will take the image I will be using and open it in here. Now I need to make a selection of the model. So I will go and select the quick selection tool and I will make a quick selection of the model portrait. Just like this. And then while I'm still in the quick selection, I will right click and choose feather. And I will put 0.5 pixel feather in here. And I will press OK. Alright. Now I will select the model image and I will press Ctrl J. And now I have it in a new layer. I will name it model. Let me delete this one in here. Alright, now I want to make the background of this image bigger so we'll have enough space to create our effect. So I will go and select the crop tool and I will expand it a little bit from here and in here. And I will click on this check mark to commit my change. Alright, now we'll go to adjustments in here and I will choose solid color. I will keep the color white for now and I will press OK. I will take it and put it under the model layer and I will name it BG for background. Alright, now we'll select the model layer and I will desaturate it. So we'll press Ctrl Shift U or you can go to Image, Adjustment and choose Desaturate. Now I will go and open the second image I will be using. So I will take it and open it in a new tab. And I will drag it to the other tab in here. I will name it Mountain. And I will change its opacity around 50%. This way I can see where I want to replace it before I will start working on it. Now I know that I want this cloud to be in the other direction. So I will press Ctrl T and then I will right click and choose flip horizontal. And now I have the clouds where I want them. Also, I want this top of the mountain to be right in the forehead of the model in here. So I will press shift and drag to make the image bigger. And I will place the image to fit where I want it. And I will one click on this check mark. And I will change the opacity back to 100%. Now I will select the model layer and I will press Ctrl and one click on it to load the selection of the model. Now I will select the mountain layer and then I will one click on this layer mask icon. And as you can see, this will create a silhouette of the model. Alright, now we'll make a copy of this model layer. So I will press Alt and make a copy of it and put it on the top of the mountain layer. And I will change its blending mode to lighten. And we'll get a cool effect in here. But I will reduce the opacity of it around 50%. Now I will apply a layer mask on it. So I will go and I will one click on this layer mask icon. And I will select the layer mask in here. And then I will select the brush tool. And with a 40% in the opacity and the black is my foreground color, I will start deleting in this area. Alright, now we select the mountain layer and I will make sure that I'm on its layer mask and I will start deleting in here to reveal the face of the model. Alright, now we select the background layer and I will double click on it and I will sample a color from here and I will press OK. Now I will select the mountain layer and I will press Ctrl J to duplicate it. And then I will take the layer mask and delete it. And I will change its blending mode to lighten. And as you can see, this will create a cool effect with the clouds. But there are still other parts from the image visible. So I will apply a black layer mask on it by holding Alt on my keyboard and one click on this layer mask icon. Now I will select my brushes and with the white as my foreground color, I will start brushing in here to make only this part of the clouds visible. Alright, now we'll select this top layer and I will go to adjustments and choose solid color. And I will pick a soft pink color and I will press OK. I will change the blending mode of it to multiply, and I will set the opacity around 20%. Now we'll create a stamp visible layer. So we'll press Alt, Ctrl, Shift, E, and I will desaturate it. So we'll go to Image, Adjustment, and choose Desaturate. I will change the blending mode to Soft Light. And I will put down the opacity around 30%. And that's it. So I hope that you enjoyed and liked this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, give it a thumb up and share it, and wait for more tutorials to come. In fact, in the next tutorial, I will show you how I created this other double exposure image that you can see in here. Alright, thank you for watching and have a nice day.